as we celebrate this feast of Blessed Francis and Xavier. Silos, let us begin our prayers. One, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass intention today is all for priests living and deceased. Peace the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And the message today is about charity. We hear from the Gospel reading about the Good Samaritan. Out of the charity and the love of his heart, he helps someone who is in dire need. Let us seek forgiveness when we have not lived from the heart of charity. Lord, we have sinned against you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Set our hearts aflame, O Lord, with the spirit of your charity, we pray, that we may always think thoughts worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you sincerely in our brothers and sisters, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, I am amazed that you are so quickly forsaken the one who called you by the grace of Christ for a different gospel. Not that there's not another, but there are some who are disturbing you and wish to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even if we or an angel from heaven should preach to you a gospel other than the one that we have preached to you, let that one be accursed, as we have said before. And now I say again, if anyone preaches to you a gospel other than the one that you received, let that one be accursed. Am I now currying favor with human beings and God? Or am I seeking to please people? If I were still trying to please people, I should not be a slave of Christ. Now I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that the gospel preached by me is not of human origin. For I did not receive it from a human being, nor was I taught it. But it came through a revelation of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart, in the company of the assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
The works of his hands are faithful and just. Sure are all his precepts, reliable forever and ever, wrought in truth and equality.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
He has sent deliverance to his people. He has ratified his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. His praise endures forever.
The Lord will remember his covenant forever.
Alleluia.
What must I do to inherit eternal life? Jesus said to him, "What is written in the law? How do you read it?" He said in reply, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your being, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself." He replied to him, "You have answered correctly. Do this, and you will live." But because he wished to justify himself, he said to Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man fell victim to robbers as he went down from Jerusalem to Jericho. They stripped and beat him and went off, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the road, but when he had saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. Likewise, a Levite came to the place, and when he saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. But a Samaritan traveler who came upon him was moved with compassion at the sight. He approached the victim, poured oil and wine over his wounds, and bandaged them. Then he lifted him up on his own animal. He took him to an inn and cared for him. The next day he took out 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper with the instructions, 'Take care of him. If you spend more than what I've given you, I shall repay you on my way back.' Which of these, in your opinion, was neighbor to the robber's victim?" He answered, "The one who treated him with mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's message is about charity. I spoke about charity at the masses this last weekend, but really the gospel really calls us to focus on charity. So out of curiosity, I'd like to get on the iPhone and kind of play around with it to see what the iPhone says about the biblical definition of charity. And this may surprise you. It did me. I had forgotten this. Charity, in Christian thought, the highest form of love, signifying the reciprocal love between God and man that is made manifest in the unselfish love of one fellow's man. Paul classified a description of charity as found in the New Testament. Heard about that. What surprised me is I've forgotten it's the highest form of love. You know, I guess I just didn't think about it. And so what I started to think about was the Sacred Heart of Jesus and how we're called. We put on that Sacred Heart of Jesus the day we're baptized. We put on the heart of Christ. And so I think it's really important that we're reminded today by this gospel reading that charity is the greatest act if you want to have a loving heart. You know, we can love one another, we can do things for one another, we can try to be the best, but without charity, without that love of neighbor, we're nothing. Who's our neighbor? Our co-worker, the person that lives next door to us, the fellow parishioner, our children's friends, parents. No, our neighbor is everyone. Our neighbor is humanity. Different way to look at it. So our charity is due to humanity, not based on what humanity has done to us, good, bad, or different, but of how Christ has touched us in our lives. So acts of charity are acts of humanity. In some respects, we're missing it today. So the lesson today is, Lord, help me to be that person that lives from that heart. Sacred Heart of Christ by being a person of charity. You know, in the first reading, St. Paul talks about don't try to be a people pleaser, right? Don't try to do a people pleaser. You know, the one we should please, always and everywhere, is our Creator, the Lord Jesus Christ. So let us go forth today, whatever our day brings, and ask the Lord to continue to give us that grace that we may have a charitable heart for all of humanity. Trusting in God's merciful love, who has given us, granted us the greatest gift of charity, his passion, death, and resurrection, let us pray for the charitable needs not only of our world, our nation, and our community of faith. For all of our bishops, our Holy Father, all those in leadership, that the Holy Spirit may continue to guide them in holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all of our leaders within this country, the United States of America, especially these days, pray for our president who has the coronavirus. Pray for all those who have the coronavirus, all those who have died from the coronavirus, all those who contract the coronavirus, that through the gift of first responders, health care givers, healing and touch may be granted to all. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who may be struggling in their faith, may the Lord console them with his promises and mercy and help them in any unbelief or disconnection. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those today who struggle from various diseases and illnesses, maybe physical, emotionally, mentally. Those who struggle physically, for this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us see today, let us pray that we see today as a gift, a brand new day, in order to grow in love and charity. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the petitions we hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious Almighty God, we thank you for this beautiful day that's ahead of us. Help us to grow in your love by being people of charity. As we offer up our prayers to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has made, and human has it made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine of human hands, become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name. For our good and all the Holy Church.
Sanctify these gifts in your mercy, O Lord, and accepting the oblation of the spiritual sacrifice, grant, we pray, that we may extend your charity to all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes
in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you in many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, Saint Francis Xavier, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with your spirit.
And now let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper.
The Holy Spirit of the Lord, our soul.
as I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Pour out the grace of your Holy Spirit, O Lord, on those who have replenished with this one bread of heaven, and refresh us, we pray, with the delights of perfect charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For the greatest act of charity shown to us is Christ's passion, death, and resurrection. He calls us to live in that through acts of charity. The greatest love that we can ever show one another is the greatest love that the Lord showed us. So let us think about a charitable act each and every day of our lives. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.